Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll discuss the deployer and learn more about how it distributes app and configuration updates to Searchhead cluster members. The deployer is a dedicated Splunk instance that synchronizes and distributes apps and certain types of configurations to Searchhead cluster members. It distributes this content in the form of configuration bundles. On the initial push to a new Searchhead cluster, the deployer distributes all bundles. Then, on subsequent pushes, it only distributes new apps and apps that have changed since the last push. Communication between the deployer and the Searchhead cluster members is one way, from the deployer to the Searchhead cluster. The deployer coordinates configuration deployment with a specific member of the Searchhead cluster, called the captain. Every Searchhead cluster has one member that will be elected as this role. The captain functions as the source control server and is responsible for coordinating replication activities among all cluster members, which includes replicating configuration updates. These are runtime changes or additions, such as knowledge objects, save searches, lookup tables, field extractions, and dashboards. Methods that trigger replication are Splunk Web, the Splunk CLI, and REST API. The cluster does not replicate any changes made directly to configuration files. Each Searchhead cluster needs one deployer and must be run on an instance that is not a member of the cluster. The processing requirements for a deployer are fairly light, so depending on the environment, the deployer could also be configured on the license manager or monitoring console. Once the Splunk instance is configured, you will need to associate the deployer with the Searchhead cluster by setting the pass4simkey attribute in server.conf. Each Searchhead cluster member and the deployer must use the same secret key to authenticate communications with each other. The secret key is set in the pass4simkey attribute within the sh clustering stanza in the server.conf file. In this example, we have used sh cluster secret key. Once the secret key is created, restart the deployer instance to encrypt the secret key. Now you are ready to start associating the cluster members to the deployer. To associate the cluster members with the deployer, use the splunk init sh cluster-config command on each searchhead. This all-in-one command will perform a number of configuration actions, point searchhead cluster members to the deployer, and configure required key parameters in the server.conf file. The first flag you will want to specify is the auth flag, which is used to provide the login credentials for the instance. The management URI flag is for providing the FQDN for the searchhead cluster member instance. Be sure not to confuse this with the URI of the deployer. The replication port flag configures the port number used by the cluster members to communicate with each other and listen for artifacts from other members. The replication factor flag defines the number of artifact copies for each search artifact. The conf deploy fetch URL flag defines the location of the deployer instance and the Splunk management port, which by default is 8089. The secret flag is the secret key used on the deployer instance. Each searchhead cluster member and the deployer must use the exact same secret key to authenticate communication with each other. Finally, the sh cluster label flag is a parameter that is useful for identifying the cluster in the monitoring console. While this parameter is optional, it is recommended to help present each searchhead cluster member in a human-readable form and allows them to be more easily identified. If you configure one member with this parameter, you must perform it on all members of the cluster, including the deployer. You will need to restart Splunk on each of the searchhead cluster members for the changes to take effect. Now let's take a closer look at configuration bundles, which are stored on the deployer in the Splunk Home, Etsy, SH Cluster, Apps folder. The bundles are deployed to the searchhead cluster members when either the apply SH cluster command is run, or when a new member joins or rejoins the cluster. When running the SH cluster command, the target parameter is required and specifies the URI and management port of any member of the cluster. The management port by default is 8089. The auth parameter specifies the login credentials of the deployer. When a target receives a bundle from the deployer, the member will notify the captain, and the captain syncs the configuration bundle deployment to other members. Deployed configuration bundles are installed in the Splunk Home Etsy Apps folder on the searchhead cluster members. Apps in Splunk may have configurations stored in the default directory, local directory, or both. A default app configuration is pushed directly to the searchhead cluster members. A local app configuration is pushed to the captain of the searchhead cluster, then distributed to the members. When an app is deployed, the subset of files used by the indexing layer is distributed by the captain of the searchhead cluster. This process is known as knowledge bundle replication. Bundles typically contain a subset of files, configuration files, and assets from Splunk Home Etsy System, Etsy Apps, and Etsy Users directories on the searchhead. Before you can push configuration bundles to the cluster members, you need to make sure the push mode is properly set on the deployer. The push mode is configured in Settings under the SH Clustering stanza in app.conf, and can be set globally at the system directory level and locally at the app level. App-specific settings take precedence over the global push mode policy. There are four push mode options available for the deployer, but the recommended method is to use Merge to Default, unless you have a specific use case to employ another push mode. If a push mode is not specified, it will default to Merge to Default, except for built-in apps, such as the Search app, which default is Local Only mode. Using the Merge to Default push mode from the deployer, all settings from files in the app's local directory are merged into the corresponding files in the app's default directory. During the merging process, settings from the local directory take precedence over any corresponding settings in the default directory. So if a particular attribute is defined in both places, the merged file retains the definition from the local directory. Then the deployer pushes the merged app's default directory onto each cluster member. The full push mode would push out apps and configurations as is from the deployer. The default folder is pushed to each searchhead cluster member. The local folder is pushed to the captain, which redistributes the contents to the other members. The default only push mode only pushes the contents to the default folder. The local folder on the member is ignored. And lastly, the local only push mode will only push the app's local configurations and metadata to the cluster. Again, bundles targeting the local folder are sent to the captain, which redistributes the bundle to the other members. It is recommended to not use the deployer to push Splunk's built-in apps, such as search and reporting. This can cause corruption of the configuration files of the built-in apps. Lastly, deployer push threads allow you to push apps by implementing a parallel push policy. By default, the deployer uses a single separate thread for each member. Deployer push modes are defined in server.conf. The default setting of 1 sets the push mode to a single thread operation. In this operation, the deployer uses a single thread to push all apps and configurations to a member before sending to the next member. To set up a parallel push policy, change the deployment push thread setting to auto in server.conf and restart the deployer. In the parallel push mode, the deployer opens a channel to each cluster member simultaneously and sends the apps as fast as each member can apply them. Thanks for joining us to learn how to use the deployer to distribute app and configuration updates. To continue your journey learning about Splunk, we suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.